Come from researchers, our inventors, our innovators. In this respect, the ministry constituted a strong team of judges to assess the innovations and research results of our expo participants. The assessment was in various categories, including technology, entrepreneurs, research institutions, tertiary institutions, and junior engineering technicians and scientists. These assessments were carried out professionally and in a very transparent manner. All the winners that emerged in the first, second, and third positions in the various categories will be rewarded with 1,750,000 and 500,000 naira respectively. We are convinced that this will help us in building a new science and technology culture in our DNA. Yesterday, I spent nearly 4 hours to move around in various pavilions. I was amazed at what I saw. There is creativity from both the old and the young in Nigeria. Nigeria is definitely on the move. I was impressed with the level of research and innovation that I saw on display during this fourth edition of our Science, Technology and Innovation Expos. However, I still want our scientists to work even harder than they are currently doing. I was very happy to see many individuals in the informal sector making significant contributions to research and innovation in Nigeria. Research is not only to be done in designated laboratories. There are rooms and even the kitchen where we cook our food can, to some extent, serve as laboratories. There is an image that will continue to stay with me for a very long time to come. As I walked by the space plants in the pavilion yesterday, I stopped at some as determined by the guide. I was surprised to see two small children, a boy and a girl, as they meandered their way through the crowd that accompanied me, to stand before me and demanded that I go back to see their display stand, being one of those we did not stop to ask questions. This was yesterday. These children were primarily 6 pupils wearing their school uniform. This was clearly the Nigerian indomitable spirit on display. Inside me, I exclaimed, wow. I imagined if this could happen in any other country but our special and unique nation. I saluted their boldness, courage, determination, and perseverance. We had to go back to their stand. You needed to be there to see the smiles on the faces of these two young Nigerian children. I was also visiting around the city square in a solar-powered bed, which took advantage of Nigeria's location on the, in the tropics with sunshine all year round. A good part of the body of the vehicle was made with solar panels. I sat with the driver in front, while the government secretary and the director of science and technology promotion sat at the back. We had a live ride around the Eagle Square in this noiseless vehicle without an issue, designed and built by the Aero Quality of Technology. As I moved around the pavilion, more than ever before that there is no need for our dear country to be imported from other countries. Many of the things we now bring into our country from outside. I call on all policymakers and Nigerian investors to make time to visit the various plans in our future expo. If this happens, it will help accelerate the pace of commercialization of research results in our quest for self-reliance as a nation. Most distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to inform you that the outputs of our past three editions of the expo have led to the creation of many small-scale businesses, which we believe will soon grow into medium and large-scale enterprises. I invite the private sector to take advantage of the research results and begin prototypes to case at this expo to create wealth for both themselves and our nation, as well as employ our citizens. It is with this in mind that I am convinced that we will continue to use the science, technology, and innovation expo to create limitless opportunities for all Nigerians.
May the Almighty God bless our dear country, Nigeria.